Come. Still going?
Down.
He's breathing.
Yeah. Madeleine. Madeleine.
Bien.
Amazon, vous avez raté.
Certo. Chefe, está uma autorização para o filme?
Não.
Muito bem. Está a ser filmado.
Mas fica sem câmera, mas...
Thank you.
Espanha.
This one, here. Here.
horas são? 22.
Eu?
Sim. Just a moment, please, Mark. I'm just... Yeah.
Okay, what we've done is we've deployed the enhanced victim recovery dog into the apartment. And by experience and the training of the dog, what I've first noticed is that as soon as I came in, that the dog's very excited, and as a handler, I can pick up his body language, etc. And it would appear to me that as soon as he's come in the house, he's picked up a scent that he recognises, and he's then gone through the apartment trying to source where that scent source is coming from. And as he's worked through the house, the only two places where he picks up enough scent to give me the bark alert are in this bedroom, in this corner where he was barking. What we have to be able to understand in a situation like this is that in a hot climate, with that apartment being closed down, the scent will build up in a particular area. If there isn't a scent source in here, i.e. A physical article where the scent is emitting from, any scent residue will collect in a particular place due to the air movement of the flat, or the apartment. And what I would say in this case is that there's enough scent in that area there for him to give me a bark indication. But the source may not be in that cupboard. The source may well be in this room somewhere else, but the air is actually pushing it into that corner. But is a strong indication, I would say it's positive for the things that he's trained to find, which will be part of a separate debrief. Moving on to the other rooms, once he's found what he thinks he's looking for in this room, and we go into the bathroom and we come into this bedroom, he loses interest because he's actually found the source that he's looking for. Until we come over here, and I think you've got it on video, that when he first came in, he was quite interested in the sofa, but he didn't have access to the back of the sofa. And when he's gone behind the sofa, what I saw was that approximately in the centre of the wall where the window is, just along the tile area, between the tiles and the wall, he's been scenting there a lot stronger than he has anywhere else. And then when he's gone out over the second time, he's decided, yes, that's what I'm looking for, and that's when he's given me the bark indication. What we should understand with this dog is that he only barks when he finds something. He won't bark at any other time. The only times I've ever known him bark since I got him as a small puppy was A, for his dinner, And that's just excitement, and that's one of the training methods we use to teach him to bark when we wanted him to, and when he actually finds something. He won't bark at other dogs, he won't bark at strangers, he won't bark when somebody knocks on the door or anything like that. So again, I would say that's a positive indication.
O comprimento de ondas das luzes que utilizamos não é. Isso é um bom desenrasco. Não, não destrói nenhum vestígio biológico.
Oh, they said the waves don't destroy the biological evidence. The waves of the light.
No, but the chemical you use does.
Oh, mas ele diz o químico.
Pois.
I'm fine. Here you come. Hit. Here, come.
This is that corner, anyway.
Mm-hmm. So it's just a collection point, isn't it? Or did you get something? I didn't see it.
No, nothing in there.
Yeah,
it's
nothing in there.
This one? Yeah, it's more where the other dog was barking. Mm-hmm. Kills.
Yeah.
The second dog that we've seen work today is the crime scene dog, Keela. She will only indicate to me when she's found human blood. Only human blood, and it is only blood. And there must be something there physically for her to be able to alert to me that she's actually found something. At this point over here, where the victim recovery dog was indicated, as you saw on the video, the crime scene dog has actually given me what we call a passive indication, where she freezes in this spot here, which would indicate to me that there is some human blood there. She will find blood that's historically very old, and she will find anybody's blood, any human blood, which is important to make sure that everybody knows. The fact that there's other scientific methods being used may stop you recovering any DNA, but if you try, we'll see what happens. But she is very, very good, and when she indicates, there is always blood there.
Thank you.
Right, okay, just going to do it first.
Put the light on, yeah? You can put the light on.
Eddie, come. Here, come. In.
Back. What was I pulling out?
Yeah. What was I pulling out? The sideboard in there.
Right.
Here. Take it out.
Yeah. Good boy.
Yeah. Eddie, come. Yeah. Eddie. Come. Eddie, come. Yeah. Well, it's covered in toys. Yeah. Eddie, come. Come on. Yeah. Yeah, Eddie, come. Come.
Good boy. Yeah. Good boy, this way.
You moved it a little bit. Yeah, yeah. Eddie, here. Come.
You.
Sit.
Move. Nothing.
We've searched this apartment with the victim recovery dog, and he's shown no interest in the flat for what he's trained to find at all. So we're finished. You're writing all the time to these now. I'll get them off you because I need to do the same.
Okay, I was a shot. The week.
Wait. No, you're not having that, whatever it is. Come on, here. No! Here, Eddie!
Good boy.
Just need to check in there under that bed.
Which one?
Down.
First bed.
Can you shut that?
Think that I can walk down so I can.
We've put the victim recovery dog through this apartment, and the only interest has been in some food that he's found. Other than that, there's no interest in anything that he's been taught to tell me that he's found. Onde eles trouxeram para aqui? Lembra-se de como
Martin.
Right.
He's under the bed.
Yeah. And the dog hasn't shown any interest in this particular apartment. Apart from around the table where there was a tennis ball, which is how we reward him for finding things. As soon as we remove the tennis ball, the interest is gone. So that's a negative search.
Right. Thank you.
No.
Sorry? Here. Hey, come. Sit. Heel.
Oh, sorry.
No, heel. Heel. Oh, we searched the dog. Her searched the apartment using the victim recovery dog. No response. Negative search.
You got a flashlight?
Yeah. Do you need a flashlight?
We need to get one.
Silvia, eu só uma coisa. Tem alguma lanterna que me possa emprestar? Sim, parece. Parece. Está bem, obrigado. Estou. Sim.
Peraí, calma.
Back off from me.
Yeah.
Yes, fine, fine. Here. Yep.
Yes, can I? Yeah, no, it's open here. Yeah, so this is...
I have to look at this tomorrow in daylight. Yeah. Come back in daylight.
Yeah. Tell me, Martin, what?
No.
We've searched the outer perimeter, and there is some interest here, but it will take some further examination to see what's going on.
Yeah.
E depois eu espero dizer que... Eu preciso saber o que é que ela precisa daquele dia.
Yes.
And then we can
Thank you.
Here it comes.
Pois agora não sabemos porque ele apontou um canto onde estavam várias peças. Uma era da mãe, duas da mãe e uma não sabe quem é, pode ser duas, pode ser. Uma sim, sim. Pronto, quando a ver, já digo mais alguma coisa. Ok, até já. Para a viatura número 1. Um. Viatura número 2. Viatura número 3. Viatura número 4. Viatura número 5. Viatura número 6. Viatura número 7. Viatura número 8. Viatura número 9. E viatura número 10.
No, 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 no.
O ar-condicionado foi desligado propositadamente para não haver circulação de ar.
Yes.
We screened the vehicles using the dog, and the only reaction we've had is to the car in the far corner. I'll tell you which one it is. Damn! It's the Renault. And what we have is a reaction from the dog over here, where his head's up in the air, and he's scenting the items that he's trying to find. And when we tie him down, he picks this guy from this door. The important thing to realise is that he's picking the scent that's coming out through the seal of the door. So, using that information, I don't intend to put the dog inside the car.
Here, come.
Okay. Okay. Same place.
Yes.
Fine.
Okay.
We screened the vehicles using the dog, and the only reaction we've had is to the car in the far corner. And what we have is a reaction from the dog over here, where his head's up in the air, and he's scenting the items that he's trained to find. And when we tie him down, he picks this guy from this door. The important thing to realise is that he's picking the scent that's coming out through the seal of the door.
Thank you.
we've done is we've deployed the enhanced victim recovery dog into the apartment, and by experience and the training of the dog, what I've first noticed is that as soon as I came in, that the dog's very excited, and as a handler I can pick up his body language, etc. It would appear to me that as soon as he's come in the house, he's picked up a scent that he recognises. The second dog that we've seen work today is the crime scene dog, Keela. She will only indicate to me when she's found human blood. At this point over here, where the victim recovery dog was indicated, as you saw on the video, the crime scene dog was actually giving me what we call a passive indication, where she freezes in this spot here, which would indicate to me that there is some human blood there. She will find blood that's historically very old, and she will find anybody's blood, any human blood, which is important to make sure that everybody knows. The fact that there's other scientific methods being used may stop you recovering any DNA, but if you try, we'll see what happens. But she is very, very good, and when she indicates, there is always blood there.
Dormitorio principal de la segunda vivienda de los McCann en Praia da Luz. La policía lusa, acompañada de dos psicólogos policiales, lleva a cabo un minucioso registro. Ante la reiterada negativa de la policía británica de remitirles diferentes informes del matrimonio, deciden trazar un perfil a través de la vivienda. En un caso de rapto siempre se investiga el entorno familiar. Sorpresa ante la diferente manera con la que Kate y Jerry afrontan la desgracia. Kate parece estar de luto. En su mesilla muchas fotografías de Maddie, rodeadas de rosarios, y la Biblia, que tiene únicamente señalada con una estampa un fragmento del Antiguo Testamento en el que se lee: como ofendiste gravemente al Señor con la acción que realizaste, morirá ciertamente el hijo que te nació. Al otro lado de la cama, la lectura de Jerry, entre otros libros, este, la interpretación del asesinato. En el estudio donde Jerry escribe su blog y trabaja en la campaña para encontrar a su hija, otra sorpresa, manuales del CEOP, libros de acceso restringido a entidades policiales y gubernamentales. Ante el descubrimiento, el propio Mark Harrison, el policía británico desplazado desde Reino Unido para coordinar el caso, no da crédito. Se pregunta cómo el matrimonio ha tenido acceso a esos manuales reservados a policías. Los agentes lusos confirman así sus sospechas respecto a los contactos con los que cuentan los McCann, que para ellos se traduce en una gran presión política que a su juicio limita la investigación. Hallan también numerosos medicamentos que examinan en busca de esos sedantes que temen los McCann suministran a sus hijos la noche del 3 de mayo. Y graban los efectos secundarios que causan los fármacos que encuentran. La mayoría de ellos provocan somnolencia. Lo examinan todo, cajones, armarios, la habitación de los gemelos, que ya no duermen en cunas, sino en camas con protecciones. El informe final de este registro, a diferencia de estas imágenes sí incluido en el sumario, expone que independientemente de los curiosos y morbosos hallazgos, el único hecho que se puede determinar como tal es el comportamiento bastante diferenciado del matrimonio a la hora de hacer frente a la desaparición de Madeleine.